Good afternoon, students. Let us continue the yesterday's session. Current trends in marketing. From this first one, green marketing. First, we see the definitions of the green marketing according to American Marketing Association. According to retailing, in retailing perspective definition, green marketing is the marketing of products that are presumed to be environmentally safe. Social marketing. The development and marketing of products designed to minimize negative effects on the physical environment or to improve its quality. According to environmental marketing definition, the efforts by organizations to protect, promote, package and reclaim products in a manner that is sensitive or responsive to ecological concerns. These are the various definitions. In simple terms, students, I will explain. Green marketing refers to process of selling products or services based on their environmental benefits. That is, packaging and usage of goods may be eco-friendly. Example, recycled water bottles, recycled fabric cloths, and reusable water bottles, rechargeable batteries, and shipping bags, etc. Let us see in this figure, evolution of the green marketing. In 1980s, corporate social responsibility report with great view on company's environmental impact by ice cream seller called Ben & Jerry. He developed this green marketing concept. And in 1987, United Nations defined sustainable development, also known as Brundtland Report. Green marketing books published by the Kinner and Chakwellen Ottman. Many number of books were published and developed in the 1987. In 2000, the second wave of CSR was widespread. Next, 2005 and 6, United Nations report, book by A.I. Goran, UK, Stern report brought scientific environmental arguments to wide public in easy to understanding about the green marketing concept. These are the evolutions of the green marketing. Now let us see the characteristics of the green marketing. Green products are made through recycling, reusable and biodegradable. Contains natural ingredients, contains recycled contents, non-toxic chemicals, contains under approved chemicals, do not harm or pollute the environment, and not tested on animals, originally grown. These are the characteristics of the green marketing. Next one, green marketing mix. Students, green marketing mix, before you have already known the what are the marketing mix elements, 4 P's, that is product, price, place, promotion. On the basis of those 4 P's, we read the green marketing mix. Product, the main objective of this product is planning products are to reduce resource consumption and increase conservation of scarce resources. Price is nothing but valuing a good. The customers are willingness to pay when they have the additional value of the product. It means the features like function, design, visual appeal, taste, improved performance of your product may attract the customers to pay additional value. Next, place. Very few customers will go out of their way to buy green products. So the seller must sell the choice of where and when to make product. Promotion. Promotions are mainly concentrated on advertisements. Advertisements play important role in the promotion of green marketing products. Example, Coca-Cola introducing green plant bottles in 2020. So that the empowering the women entrepreneurs, encouraging a healthy environment. Next, coming to benefits and costs of the marketing. Green marketing. long term growth. It ensures sustained long term growth along with the profitability. Save money in the long run, although initial cost is low. Environmental aspect of marketing. It helps the companies to market their products and service, keeping the environment aspects in mind. Gaining competitive advantage. It helps in accessing the new markets and enjoying the competitive advantage. Environmentally responsible. Most of the employees also feel proud and responsible to be working for an environmental responsible companies. Promotes CSR, corporate social responsibility. Promotes CSR, corporate social responsibility means conducting medical camps, educational facilities providing, etc. Now, costs. Green spending. Instead of environmentally improving the product, some business firms try to respond to environmental challenges and pressures. Green marketing is, customers are not aware of the green marketing products. So, the companies have so many pressures and they have to overcome all these. They have to maintain public relations and create awareness about the environmental facts. Green selling. The companies produce virtually the same product, but they add some new environmental benefits in their promotion campaigns to increase the customer interest in the environment. Green harvesting. It leads to decrease in product cost. This tends to companies, most of the marketers or producers attempts to go green and harvest the market because product costs are very low for producing and they are also sell at low cost but at a premium to earn the profits, expected profits. Enviropreneur marketing. You have already listened the term that entrepreneurs. Entrepreneur, who is an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur is a creator, innovator and comes with a strategic ideas into the market. In the same way, enviropreneur means an individual or group seeks to bring the market innovative new green products. Here the time and money spent on green products may or may not be succeed in the market. So here the enviropreneur aims at producing most environmental friendly rather than producing environmental products that customers actually want. Example, instead of using polythene bags, cloth bags are manufactured. Compliance marketing. These companies that take initiative in producing green products on the basis of the regulations. On the basis of the government regulations or government instructions, companies must produce the green products. Greenwashing. Here, greenwashing is nothing but washing the minds of the customers by providing wrong information about the green marketing to destroy the green marketing concept. Some companies may exploit consumers for gaining short-term profits by creating distrust in the mind of the consumers about the green marketing. This is about the benefits and costs of the green marketing. Next, eco-labeling. Eco-labeling is environmental claim that appeals on the packaging of product. It is awarded to a manufacturer by an appropriate authority, that is ISO. ISO 14020 is guided to the award of eco-labels. Eco-market schemes launched in 1991 by the Government of India. It aims in creating consumer market awareness in respect of environment-friendly products. The aim is to encourage the customers to purchase eco-friendly products which are less harmful. Okay, now let us see here I have produced some of the eco-marketing products and services in the manufacturing sector. Soaps and detergents, paper, food items, lubricating oils, packaging material, paints and powder coating, batteries, electrical and electronic goods, food addition, wood substitutes, cosmetics, textiles, plastic products, leathers, fire extinguishers. All these products are eco-friendly products. Nowadays, some companies are introducing in services, financial services, transport service, financial services such as NEFT, ATM, e-statements by banks, next transportation services, reducing the diesel costs, reducing the diesel usage, and electrical vehicles are introducing, and medical services like free checkup camps and free medications, educational institutions like providing PPTs and digital classes to students, avoiding paper, online classes, online classes and online courses, retail services such as discouraging plastic bags, online trading, promoting green products, etc. These are the services and products of eco-labeling. And coming to last topic, let us see, it is not a last topic, it's examples. Green initiatives taken by the following companies in India. Green initiative. So for some of the companies have taken green marketing green products, HCL Environment Management Policy under HCL EcoSafe, IBM Green Solutions to Corporate Data Centers, Honda India Civic Hybrid Car, Idea Cellular Bus Shelters with constructed bus shelters with potted plants and tendril climbers, ITC Women Empowerment Supplementary Education Integrated Animal Husbandry Programs or connecting, Indus India Bank installed solar power ATMs. First Indus India Bank has installed a solar power ATMs. Maruti, greening of supply chain, reduce trash from water consumption, recycle wastage. Wipro Infotech launched a new range of desktops and laptops called Wipro Greenware. Digital tickets by Indian Railways, no polythene carry bags free, promotion of statements bills instead of paper bills, statements by banks and telecom industries, Philips LED bulbs. These companies are providing green marketing products. Students, let us recap. Today we understood the concept of the green marketing in detail. Next we continue another recent trends in the another session. Thank you.